in 15th century. In the year 1480, there at the time Europeans wanted to prepare their maps. At the same time, they discovered the Ptolemy books. Look at the board. The Europeans rediscovered the Ptolemy books, but not maps. They stumbled about by learning accurate description there and exact location, shapes. In that, he used that mathematical calculations for using that latitudes and longitudes. We observing the books. He wrote in the book about how to prepare the maps. By reading the book, they can understand it. Then they started prepare the maps. Understand? At the same time, in 15th century, new enthusiasm in the non-Arabic world. Non-Arabic means Arabs means Muslims. Non-Arabic means here Europeans. They are greatly interested. They introduced their subject cartography. New schools were emerging in entire Europe country, mostly in the European countries. Where it is? English schools were emerged. Look at this. Italian schools were emerged. French schools were emerged. And German schools also imagine that. They introduced as a subject, map making is one subject. This was greatly imbued to all the members. Their interest lent in the schools. Next, at the same time, in 1453, major incidents took place. Arabs occupied the main trade sea route. It is known as Constantinople. Arabs were occupied the Constantinople. Arabs means here Turks people, Turkish people. They occupied the Constantinople. It is very important religious place. And also it is the capital city of Roman Empire. It's known as town, Byzantine Empire. So this was occupied by Arabs. Arabs means Turks people. They did not allow others. So this is main trade sea route. So while the traders crossed across the Mediterranean Sea, and in this way all the Europeans, they tried to discover the sea routes. All the Europeans started searching for new sea routes. In this manner, Portugal people started for searching, and Spain people started for searching that new trade routes, and English people, England, they also searched for new sea routes. Almost all Western Europe countries, they started to search for new sea routes. In this manner, in Columbus discovered sea route to America. He discovered that America, Columbus, in the year 1493. He went westward and finally he discovered the sea route to America. And next, Vasco da Gama. He discovered the sea route to India in the year 1498. First he reached to Calicut area. He met with Indian king, Hindu king, Raja Jamaran. He invited him. Okay, in this manner he discovered sea route to India. Actually, so this was happening. Similarly, other sea discoverers discover also there. Right? Now, coming to that 16th century, what happened in that? 16th century. In 16th century, Holland emerged as a major trading power. More trade, mostly that maritime trade. And Arabs were, mostly Holland people were, they had a maritime supremacy over the trade. At the time, number of geographers also there is also very important. Number of geographers are, and map making was very prominent in the Holland because they traders. So one of the important geographer and cartographer, he was known as Gerardus Mercator. Look at the board, Gerardus Mercator. He was also known as father of cartography. Okay, he used a one method, it's known as Mercator projection. What is that Mercator's projection? By using that Mercator projection, all the members, all the Europeans and other people, they started to prepare the world map. Understand this? What is that Mercator's projection? He used a, look at this. So Mercator's device, it is a method for showing the correct shapes and directions and coordinates, but with the distortion of the sizes and distances. So this is known as Mercator's device. Mercator's projection means it is a one device to prepare the map. It was used by all the Europeans and they prepared that world maps. Okay, so next in this discuss about Britishers. You know about, you already learnt in 7th class about Britishers. The Britishers established India, an empire. The Britishers occupied India and they established their empire in India. First one battle, major battle, 1757, Battle of Plassey, very important Battle of Plassey. Then this was the first beginning of the traditions. They had a power, they gained a power in 1757 in India. Next, in 1764, this is very important, 1764, one war was happened. This is known as Boxer War. Boxer is the place in Haryana. In that Boxer War, the Britishers won the war and they gained a complete political power in India in 1764. Okay. Then the Britishers wanted to search for interior places of India. What is there inside of that? So that's why the Britishers needed one map for India. Understood now? Who prepared that first map of India? Britishers only. One of the person there, I will tell you. So that's why the British department, the British government, they established one department for preparation of the map. It's called as Survey of India. Survey of India. And Britishers appointed that first surveyor general also. Who was that first surveyor general? James Rennell. James Rennell. He started preparation of the map. First he wanted to survey, conducted one survey, and finally account that survey, he prepared one map. Look at this. This is okay. And next, another important survey there. This was also started by Britishers in the year 1802. One important survey is in the year 1802, William Lambton. William Lambton, he began a most important survey in the world. This was started from the India, Chennai. Because why he selected the Chennai? Because every heights we are measuring from mean sea level only. So Chennai is located in the sea coast area. So he started from Chennai. And finally, the survey completed up to that Himalayas. But this survey was completed by one person. He was known as Sir George Everest. Sir George Everest. He completed that, this complete geographical survey. Okay, Sir George Everest. So he completed that to North India related Himalayas, complete measurements of Himalayas, including that heights and lowland areas, everything. And finally measured the height of Everest. It is located in Himalayan region only. First he only measured that height of the Everest peak. That's why the Everest peak is named after his survey, Sir George Everest. Understood all? Thank you.
మరిన్ని వీడియోస్ కోసం మా ఛానల్ని సబ్స్క్రైబ్ చేయండి, షేర్ చేయండి, అండ్ ఫైనల్లీ క్లిక్ ఆన్ ది బెల్ ఐకాన్. థ్యాంక్ యూ.